A B C D E F G H I J K L M N O P L M N O P Q R S T U V W X Y Z. Hi guys, this is Devnath from Officers IAS Academy, and you're watching a new video, Learning River Names Through Songs. Now you wonder why I sang that song in the first place, right in the beginning of the video. This is a song that we all of us remember from our childhoods very fondly. Since then, we've never forgotten that song or even the English alphabet, which is the purpose of that song in the first place, right? We've never been able to forget the English alphabet, and we're using it very comfortably. Now, this device was kept with a specific purpose in mind, to make it easier for us to remember things, right? Now, as we grow into adults, we forget these techniques and we think it is too childish to use these techniques or devices for an exam as big as the IAS exam, the UPSC exam, right? But in my opinion, you're never too old to become young again. So I thought I could employ this technique of learning things through songs to river and its tributaries. Now this river and tributaries thing, this question, these type of questions often finds place in the UPSC prelims exam. You at least find one question in the examination paper. And the tributaries are given in such a way that it definitely confuses you. And most of the time you pick out rivers or tributaries elsewhere, right? For example, you pick out the tributaries of Krishna in the place when it is asked for tributaries of Cauvery. To avoid this, I devised a new song, the Cauvery song as I call it, to remember the tributaries of the Cauvery, right? Now I'll start with that song. I'll sing that song once. You can go ahead and rewind it back and listen to the song again for you to be able to remember it in a better fashion. So we start with the Cauvery.
Harangi Hemavati Arkavati Shimsha, all of these are the left bank tributaries of the Cauvery. This is how you remember river names.
Again.
Harangi Hemavati Arkavati Shimsha, all of these are the left bank tributaries of the Cauvery. This is how you remember river names.
Going to the right bank, right?
Lakshmana Tirtha Swarnavati Amaravati Kabini Bhavani, and the Noyil on the right hand side. This is how you remember river names.
Again.
Lakshmana Tirtha Swarnavati Amaravati Kabini Bhavani, and the Noyil on the right hand side. This is how you remember river names.
So that was about for Cauvery. Now you can definitely use this, and I guarantee you that if you recite this song for say two days, three days, as you're doing your daily chores, reading the newspaper, eating, taking bath, it is one mode of revising all that you've learned from your textbooks. When you read it from the textbooks, it gets all too boring, but if you sing it as a song, it is all too easy for you to remember. From that, we'll go ahead to the Krishna River. Now for this, I used a different mnemonic technique. If you use the same mnemonic technique as the Cauvery or the same tune as the Cauvery, you'll probably get end up getting confused between these two and pick out tributaries of Cauvery for the river Krishna. So I've used a different mnemonic technique, which is the sloka. If you see from time immemorial, the sloka method has been used to transmit knowledge and to remember knowledge, right? This is one method that has been used since the Vedic period, right? Astrological books, geometrical treatises, or any other thing that is there to transmit to people and for them to help remember it better, have been composed through slokas. Now you can use this sloka meter for the Krishna River. Let's see how. For the left bank tributaries of the Krishna, we have
Bhima Dhindi Peddavagu Musi Haliyamunneru Paleru on the left hand side are the tributaries of Krishna.
Again,
Bhima Dindi Peddavagu Musi Haliyamunneru Paleru on the left hand side are the tributaries of Krishna.
Moving to the right tributaries.
Venna Koina Panchaganga Dhud Ganga Ghataprabha Malaprabha Tungabhadra are the tributaries on the right.
Again.
Venna Koina Panchaganga Dhud Ganga Ghataprabha Malaprabha, Tungabhadra are the tributaries on the right.
Hope this this helped you. Now to say, this is a very experimental video, not a technique that many of the people have tried elsewhere, right? Usually people give you statements to remember, and this is how you remember tributaries generally using mnemonic techniques. But I found in my own experience when I use these statements, the statements itself get confused. You use a different statement for a different river, but you have a specific song and a specific meter for rivers. It's all too easy for you to remember. Now for us to, I told you it's an experimental video, right? For us to continue with these techniques, it is very important that you give your feedback, because I do not know personally how you receive to this, how you take to this. So if it is of really any use to you, if it really helps you to remember names of tributaries, you can comment in the comment section and like our video and share our video, so that we know that we can make more of such videos. And if you have any specific topic for which you would like me to make songs upon for you to remember better, you can comment in the comment section. All the best.